Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Mahaba to everybody. So yesterday I had to give an interview and it was about practicing truth. So there is this question: when we look on truth, what is a truth? No. A truth can never be an absolute truth. Because as long as we are in this body, as long as we are in our way, the way we think in our mind, we have a subjective truth, right? But the truth, what is true for you, can change over time. As long as you are inclined in a drama position, which means that you find many aspects in your life not complete, not fine, not good, they are not working for you. You have a certain truth about your life. You have a certain truth about people. And when you go beyond the drama point, when you reach to this point, what we call in Sufism Nafs al-Mutmainna, your truth reaches to what we would call the relative truth. In the relative truth, what will be true for you is just what is. Just what is becoming true. Yeah. So, for example, lying is not the opposite of truth. When someone tells a lie, he tries to bend the truth towards him or towards her, which will never work. So lying is not the opposite of truth. The opposite of truth is denial. What we cannot accept to be true, what is difficult for us to see or to understand, we deny it. And that is the reason why even the religious, the spiritual people cannot find an agreement on certain points. Actually, in the fundamentals, they cannot even find an agreement. One says God does not exist. No. One says it exists, but it exists in many ways. There are many gods. The others say we come and we go. The others say we only come one time. No. It is according what you believe. And what you believe, you make it the truth. And you say, if you don't believe as me, you are wrong. No? And because it is in the books, but all of them, they have other books. Yeah. So at the end of the day, you know, if even those people who are supposed to be open-minded, open-hearted, if they cannot find an agreement, what about the rest? What about yourself? No. So we are in this time. Yet we are in this time. It is going to change. But we are still in this time where we have separations, where we have walls between the spiritual views and whatsoever. Now, the more science will come into play, the more the science will acknowledge certain things, but it will do it in a neutral way, many things have to be reviewed. Now, one of the latest discoveries they have done is that there is a source field. No? I don't think they call it source field, but there is a field which is behind everything, no? Which includes everything. And they found out that this field has a kind of intelligence, no? So, in other words, you could call it the God field if you want to say so, no? But it would be difficult to name it like this because then this will be again bringing trouble here and there. So I like very much the word source because one thing is for certain, you did not bring yourself here And if you are not completely foolish, you will not take yourself away from here, right? But we also know that there has been a before. And we also know some way that there is an after. So life did not just start in the moment you arrive here. No. And we are not talking about reincarnation. We are talking about just the simple fact that you know you have a place where you have been before you came here, right? Now, how you want to call that? And there will be a place where you are after, right? Then some people believe that they have come again and again and again, no? Now, I advise you an intelligent position. And the only real intelligent position is forget about it. Forget about the idea you have lived many times. Even so, I'm not saying it did not happen. It might be like this, but you're not able to handle your life even now. It is just one life. You're not even able to handle it in a very smooth way, right? Imagine you would remember 10 lifetimes with all the emotions, with all the things. Then you discover, oh, in one lifetime, my girlfriend was before my father, or was my mother, or it was my sister, whatever. Imagine you would realize in the very moment that you sit with your wife and you understand clearly she has been your mother before. You could not relate to her in the same way anymore. It would complicate and it would ruin all your life. Therefore, for good reason, no one has really a memory so far, and those people who have, they will not look particular how everything has happened and this and this and this and this and this and this. It will be just a chaos. So, for this reason, all the masters, they say, don't look in that direction. Don't look there. There is no need. It will be just for complication. It will not help you. It will not really benefit you in this way. But I'm not saying it did not exist. Yeah. I'm just saying to you, don't have a look. Yeah. I say it exists simply out of my own experience. And second, it has a kind of sign. There is a signature in everywhere. You know, there is a tree and he has always new leaves. There are plants, they come back and so on and so on and so on. There is a cyclic movement everywhere, you know? And there is a consciousness all over which never comes and never goes. So it is a question of you. It is not a question of matter. It's not a question of facts. It is a question of viewing, no? So the truth will change according to the level you are. When you are out of your drama point, as we said before, everything becomes relative, no? It will be totally different. You will not be identified anymore with this or that. You will just see what is, whatever it is, even a lie can be true. You understand everything, it is just an expression. And whatever is this expression, it creates a reality. And this reality, you would say, is the truth. In our tradition, we are not saying God is the truth. We turn it around and we say the truth is God. So you are born in truth. Everyone is born in truth. And the truth is possible to apply it at every moment, no matter what your emotional situation is. It is the only tool you have, which is a divine tool you are born with. Love, for example, which is another divine tool and another divine characteristic. You cannot apply love at any moment in your life. But the truth you can, because you're the owner of it. And if you progress in your development, you will become the owner of other divine elements, characteristics, let's say so. And finally, you will understand you are Khalifatullah, you are the representative for this moment of life you have as a divine being on earth. No. And you correspond permanently with the divine field as the only field which is all the time there. So the ego takes it all for itself. And in order to survive, it has to create separation. It has to create walls. It has to say, it is not like that and not like that. And on a certain level, you need this in the beginning to survive. Our master used to say, if the truth would be revealed like in one shot to you, in one moment, the truth about yourself, the truth about existence, the truth about reality, you would just die. You could not comprehend it. You would have a heart stroke and a brain stroke at the same time. No? So there is steps. There is steps. There is a knower under you. There are some people they know less than you. And there is people they know more than you. The mind, the ego mind thinks, I know everything. I know the most. I'm the most brilliant knower. Well, once you start to know something and you go a little bit higher, the first thing you know is that you practically don't know anything of what could be known. Yeah. The amount of what could be known is so infinite that this little tiny spark, which we call our knowledge, is nothing. And what we call our knowledge is mostly the belief of something you have been told and you have been identified with it. It is not your knowledge. It is not your thing. So don't make a war out of something which is not yours. Yeah. Do not create any hatred of something which is not yours and you cannot prove it. You cannot say to somebody, don't say this, because it is not written there. Yeah. What kind of logic is that? Yeah. There was not a single prophet who was not in absolute opposition to the knowledge of his time. Read the history. No. There would not be an Abraham appeared if he would have followed the society and the religious people at their time. They would not have appeared a Jesus, yeah, if he would have just followed the religious world at his time. And they would have certainly not appeared a Muhammad, peace upon all of them, if he was not absolute by himself and by his own truth. So you will not be questioned what another person believes. You will be questioned about your own knowledge, what you know, and what is your acting on what you know. Now look at your acts. Are you absolutely in line with what you believe? Are you absolutely in tune, in the same position of what you believe? Are you coherent with your belief? And you will find that within 24 hours, you are going a little bit here, you're going a little bit there, right? And that is the human thing you carry still, no? Like Rumi said one time, when someone criticized him and he said, oh, Rumi, you're not consequent in your talking. One day you talk like this, one day you talk the opposite of it. He said, well, if you look for coherence, for 100% perfection, you have to go from this world. So also We said to our sheikh one time, Maulana, last week you said the opposite of what you said today. Yeah, how can we understand? He said, last week was last week. Today is today. It's not the same always. Yeah. So Sufi people call themselves the son of their times. No? And you have to have a feeling of what is going on around you, of what is happening. And there happens a lot at that moment. We are in transition. The world as we know, the world as it functions now, it is shaking. We don't know if it is going to break in pieces, absolutely, but we know certain things. One for sure, we will not be able to continue the way it continues at the moment. Yeah. It is not going to work. Yeah. We will not be able to continue like that. It is a crazy, crazy, crazy world at the moment. No. So, not to put more craziness in it. Be humble. Try to be humble. No. Don't claim anything. Speak of what you have experienced. Yeah. And you cannot tell me I'm wrong just because I had these experiences. And I cannot tell you you are wrong because you have your experiences. That is the law of respect. What you experienced, it is true for you. Finish. Yeah. What I experienced, it will be my truth. Yeah. Have that respect. Cultivate that respect. If someone says, I experienced God does not exist. Okay. What is the problem? Does it hurt me? Does it hurt me? Does it violate me if someone believes different than me? No. Why should it do that? Yeah. So if it hurts anybody, what I'm saying, I'm sorry. I'm not intending to hurt anyone's belief. And if it shakes you, you must think about it. Why does it shake you? Belief is belief. Knowing is knowing. Yeah. And there is a belief which reaches certainty, right? Don't make your head nervous. Don't make your mind nervous. Yeah. You only have to ask yourself, am I happy? Am I content with my life? Am I in peace with my life situation? If you can say, I am in peace, absolutely in peace, congratulations, that's what we want. And if you feel there is something missing and you don't know how to do or where to go or how to solve it, and maybe there is, you read something which can help you, go there and use it. That is all. So thank you very much for your time, and may Allah bless all of you and hear you soon again. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All the best to you. Thank you.